podcast.
No, it got released already.
Oh, it did? Oh, shit. Podcast number 23. Topic tonight is she must earn your respect. How much y'all get? He don't fight. I fight. This nigga Randy ain't fighting nobody.
Say flight, but
how much I get for a fight?
Yeah, maybe it is a fight.
Well, it depends. At the very beginning, it's only a few thousand. It's never too crazy.
Yeah.
All right, hit him with the music, Randy. We waiting.
I gotta see what we got.
Like, you got mad music. Just play some of your music. It don't matter.
Play nigga, this is all my music.
play something until. Fucking play the Bryson Tiller, nigga. Come on. I need something. We already started. I'm gonna play some shit.
Nah, I got it. That's my shit right now.
Put that on the speaker.
Yeah, I got it.
Podcast number 23. Let's get it started. Make sure y'all don't go anywhere. Tune in and pay attention. It's a really good episode.
Connected to Bluetooth.
Oh, damn. If yesterday was 23, then today 24. I'm fucking up.
I'm bad.
My bad, guys. It's episode 24. I mean, you know,
he'd be having one number. He just keeps saying.
My loyal followers keeping me updated. Yo, good luck, Esteban.
Hey, on the 100th anniversary, you're going to be like, welcome to episode 21 of the podcast.
Talk to me, sweetie. Speak how you feel.
This shit is so hard.
I need for you to keep it real with me because I'm going to keep it real.
But I'm yours still.
I need you like a love, still I'm always trying to keep the peace with you. Still I swear to God, I'm in my pain with me. I be on it. I'm over here watching Spider-Man now on my TV. That shit fire.
Get you at your max, baby. Turn you up. Get back and relax with me. Burn it up. We fight again. But I'm tired of doing this again.
Oh, shit. I didn't even know that was on.
Tell the gang, call your friends and leave.
This nigga said, I know I'm toxic, but I can't help it.
Hey.
We about to get into the podcast after the song. You know what I'm saying? We got to start with the intro. Yeah, me too.
Hold up. Who gonna leave who? At this point,
song is talking about respect. They talking about something.
You feel so out of character to play a role. Sometimes you gotta break your heart to save your soul. Yeah, I know. But I saw so and so the other day and shit. I got a weird feeling about it. He said he talked to you, but you tell me everything. So
what was it, Randy? Let's get started.
There's still something guilty about it.
I ain't hearing what he's saying.
All right.
She don't be respecting.
Guys, we get to the questions after the podcast is done. What's up, Larry? How you doing? We're gonna get to the questions after we finish the podcast. Podcast only lasts for about 30-20 minutes. So I'm gonna get into the topic. And when you're done, you guys can actually send your questions to the chat or you could join the live and we could talk about it. All right, so let's get it started. So why she must respect you. And I'm gonna tell you this. It's so true, and I took notes on it because I just gotta stay a little more organized because you know the following start to grow more. So you gotta try to be a tad bit more professional. You know, speaking of professional, fucking TikTok, they not uploading my fucking videos. I upload the video and the shit staying at zero views. They not pushing my shit out.
You're getting blackballed, blood.
Because I'm speaking too much fucking truth. That's that bullshit. But anyway, all right, listen. Women respect men who don't respect them. I know that sounds crazy, but let me explain. For example, you know what I'm saying? Like, a guy that's not willing to just, you know, given to her just because she's a female. For example, you know what I'm saying? You know, I wonder why they always say, like, why girls like the bad boys, why girls like, you know, the gangsters. Because those kind of guys are not willing to break their frame. Those kind of guys aren't willing to give up their beliefs to satisfy them. For example, if you walk up to a girl, you talk to a girl, you know what I'm saying? And she's talking to you and you come with compliment. Hey, baby. Oh, you're so beautiful. Oh, and she'd be like, oh, don't touch me because I don't like, or she says, oh, don't call me beautiful because I don't like that. Everybody be calling me beautiful.
She's telling the truth.
But if you say, my bad, baby. What you want me? Don't call me baby. Oh, my bad, baby. A nigga like me. What? Learn to take a compliment. Yeah, with your ungrateful ass. That's what I would say to her. You know what I'm saying? Learn to take a compliment. A guy that's coming to her and trying to talk to her, that's just not giving in to her. For example, I'll give you guys an example. I was going to do this later on, but it was a while back. I was talking to a girl. I got her number. And, you know, I'm not short, but I'm not super tall. I'm average height. You know what I'm saying? About 5'10", you know what I'm saying? But if I put my shoes on, I'm 5'11", maybe a little taller. If I got some Tims on, I'm definitely hit 6 feet. You know what I'm saying? But she tried to clown me. So I'm talking to her. She was like, oh, you know what? You kind of short. I ignored it. I didn't pay it no mind. So I'm keeping talking. Mind you, this girl's like 5'4". Talking about I'm short. I'm almost a foot taller than this bitch. And she got the nerve to talk about I'm short. And then she goes on to say, oh, she was like, will you get that cheap ass looking jacket? And I had enough. So I was like, you know what? I was like, well, okay, then a hot breath. What, did you decide to chew some gum or get some Tic Tacs before you talked all that shit? And she was like, oh. I was like, yeah, you throw that shit, I'm going to throw it right back. Don't think you going to come with me and think you're going to get respect and you not respecting me. No. When they throw that shit back at you, you throw it right fucking back at them. And the reason why some of you guys get friend zoned, a reason why some of you guys don't get to bag the girl is because y'all just give in to her. She come at you and you thinking, oh, just because, oh, she's a female, we got to respect. And I blame fucking society, because society tell, oh, just because she's a female, you got to respect her. She's a girl. She's a lady. You don't talk to. Nah, fuck that. That bitch being disrespectful, I'm going to be disrespectful right back. If you talking like a lady, then I'll treat you like a lady. And I end up getting that girl's number, believe it or not. After that, she was like, oh, damn, you mad mean. I was like, no, I'm not. I'm giving you the same energy you giving me. When I called that, when I said, okay, hot breath, I had enough. I'm like, listen, bitch, you ain't going to be talking to me crazy. And then after she gave me, she was, do my breath really stink? I didn't want to tell her no. Her breath didn't really stink. It was just a little, it was
you
a little hot.
Say
it was a little hot. I was like, it's all right. It ain't, you know what I'm saying? You could use a piece of gum. And it wasn't that bad, but you know, she was feeling herself. So I had to bring her down a little bit. I had to bring her down a little bit. But the point is, you can't give in to these females. And why do you think that guys, you know, the girls always like the bad boys? You know what I'm saying? And on a deeper level, it goes to where you, this nigga said, that's why I keep my gun ready. Idris, what are you talking about? Oh, he said gum. but the point is, on a deeper level, it's a guy that's not willing to break his masculine frame. It's not a guy that's willing to break his beliefs just to give in to her. And when you do that, you're gaining her respect, especially if you're talking to a pretty ass girl. I'm telling you, pretty girls, first of all, pretty girls don't get approached like that. And even me sometimes, and not that I'm afraid, it's just like, damn, that bitch is bad, but I look busted. Like, I look busted right now. I'm outside wearing pajamas. I ain't got a haircut. I know my breath stink. I ran out to the store right quick, and I ain't brushed my teeth. She gonna call me hot breath. So, you know what I'm saying? A lot of time, pretty girls don't even get approached. So when you do approach them, and you approach them on some regular shit, like, oh, how you doing? What's your name? You from around here? Oh, okay. You know what I'm saying? What you doing around? Oh, you go shopping around? Okay. What you just buying some groceries? You know what I'm saying? You talking to a regular, and then she gonna shit test you. She was like, oh, we walking in the store. You're not gonna hold the door for me? I'd be like, what's wrong with your hands? You can't be a bitch. You gotta throw it right back at her. You gotta, cause they not used to that. And when she sees a guy that's not willing to compromise himself, not willing to, you know what I'm saying, give up his frame, give up his beliefs, you know what I'm saying? That turns her on. Because it's not something she's used to. Most guys aren't doing that. And I'm always referred to this. Why do you think 70% of divorces are initiated by women? Because men don't know how to navigate through relationships. Everybody falls into that society norm of saying, oh, I'ma just give my happy wife, happy life. That's bullshit. Happy wife, happy life. That's why they divorcing y'all asses. The happy wife, happy life concept is absolute fucking bullshit. And don't fall for it. It's cap. It's 100% cap. And it doesn't work.
It's not going to work if you get off to a bad start.
It doesn't work. I'm telling y'all, it doesn't work. Because if she don't respect you, if you don't make her respect you, that relationship is not going to work. Why do you think that some girls get tired of guys? They don't like guys that can walk all over. You ever see the girl? You ever see the like those skits and they're like the guy's checking her? Oh damn! Oh, like, oh, what was it? When he was like, it was a TikTok, and he was like, oh, you, I'm gonna go home. No, you gonna sit your ass down. I'm gonna make you some food, and then I'm gonna dick you down. She's like, oh, okay, and then like on the side, she like sticking her tongue out, all happy and shit that she got put in check, because that's the type of man that's earning her respect. And those type of guys, most of those guys are guys that like are thuggish or just don't give a fuck. Most guys that grown up in like a family that are just even not even a family, just have a whole bunch of women in their lives that's telling them all the time. And it has this repetition of, oh, I got to respect the woman. I got to respect the woman. Just because she's a female, just because she got a pussy, that don't mean you respect her. No, that bitch got to earn that respect. Don't think, I got to respect. No, fuck that. If she ain't coming with respect, she ain't getting it. And that's, remember the motherfucker that went live with me that time? He was like, oh, you got to respect your black queens. Oh, you
same pigmentation as your mother.
Yeah, you know, the black queen is the original woman. You got to be able to die for your black. Get the fuck out of here. I ain't dying for no bitch that ain't giving me the bare minimum respect. I don't give a fuck what race she is. Talking about you owe black. What the fuck? No, shut the fuck up. I don't owe. Only person I owe is my motherfucking mother. Even by religious standards. That's the only person I owe. The rest of these bitches, I don't owe them shit. They ain't doing shit for me. I didn't come out their vagina. They ain't pay for shit. They ain't raise me. They ain't feed me not one fucking day in my life. That's like saying I'm going to just give a random bitch all my respect. No, get the fuck out of here. If she come with respect, then she going to earn respect. Other than that, I'm not giving nobody respect that don't deserve it. And it's on a deeper level. It's on a, even on a deeper level. My brother, my king. Look like they in the chat talking about my brother. He was like, oh, listen here, my brother. You gotta respect your black queens.
Come on, my brother.
Listen here, my brother, my king. You know, the black woman is the original. Shut the fuck up. Ain't nobody trying to hear that bullshit. Get the fuck out of here. If she's respectful, then I'm going to respect her. And I don't give a fuck. I don't.
She got the same pigmentation as your mother, my brother.
Talking about I don't owe all women. No, I only owe my mother. That's the only person I owe.
For the necessity of the system that we go through, we have to get together and come as one in unity, my brother.
Yeah, you motherfucker tripping. You motherfucker tripping. And listen, y'all remember that stand up with Chris Rock, and he was like, how you can never make a woman happy. Mm-hmm. It's the truth. And the only way you can come close to making a woman happy is by making yourself happy. How? If you say, I'm going to put me first, you know what I'm saying? And she should never come first. There's always something that should come first before her, because if she's a priority, then you're giving her too much attention. Then she's going to get tired of you. She's going to get bored. Why do you think girls all the time say, I get bored so fast? Because you're giving her too much attention. Have a hobby. Go fucking running. Go to the gym. You know what I'm saying? Get some money. And then even before that, your mom should come first. Until you get married. Until you marry that woman and she start bearing children, she should not come even second. And that's why women say they get bored so fast, because you're making her so much of a priority. But the only way to come close to making a woman happy is to make yourself happy first, by staying on your purpose, by not giving up your beliefs, but not giving into her ego. When you give into her ego, meaning, oh, I don't want you to do that. Like some girl was just texting me on my DMs. Some girl, because girls message me all the time, because I don't use the dating apps, but I put my Instagram there. You know what I'm saying? So I get a lot of girls that add me all the time and trying to hit me up. And she was like, oh, hey. So I'm just talking to her, giving a regular conversation. And she was like, oh. What she said, she was like, oh, you better be in bed. Oh, you better be home.
I was like,
I sent, you know, the LeBron face where he's like, I sent to that face. I said, excuse me? She was like, I'll laugh my ass off. I'm like, listen. I was like, listen, we don't do that over here. I leave with respect. You respect me and I respect you. I'm a grown ass man. I pay rent. I live on my own. Ain't nobody fucking telling me to fucking, I better be in, bitch, if I want to stay out until fucking tomorrow. My mother don't even tell me I better be home. I left the state for fucking a day and a half. Now ain't nobody fucking question me. I mean, Randy did, but he was the same way you at.
I didn't know.
He just didn't know. Ain't nobody fucking questioning me. So for you to fucking tell me, oh, you better, I don't, she was like, oh, I was just joking. I'm sorry. Yeah, you better be fucking sorry. And that's the same thing y'all need. Don't let nobody talk to you fucking crazy. You check that shit at the fucking door. ASAP. We don't play that shit over here. We don't play that shit. If somebody try to, even a little joke, you got to keep your frame. And that's what's going to make them respect you. That's what's going to make them like you more. When you put them bitches in check.
Otherwise, she's going to see herself as above you.
It's crazy. It's crazy. You can't fall into her ego. And that's, I'm telling you, that's why a lot of y'all get friend zoned, because y'all have these girls y'all talking to and y'all think, oh, I'm going to go to the slut walk with her and to support her. I'm going to support all her feminist things. You ain't sticking up for yourself. She don't respect you on that level to be a man.
To the slut walk, Blair?
I would never. Oh, she's a feminist. We got to respect our woman. No, nigga. The fuck? She can't respect you. The fuck is you talking about? I'm gonna go to the slut walk with her. She's just being a lady. This isn't 1960s anymore. They can express themselves.
But if you called her a slut, she gonna fucking cancel your ass.
That's bullshit, because they like being called sluts too. They like that too. You fucking them. Oh, you my dirty little slut. Yes, daddy. They like all that shit. That's bullshit. You break all laws. You break all rules when you fucking, when you refuse to accept all that bullshit. What you trying to get into? What you trying to get into? Seriously. Seriously.
Slut?
Oh, yeah. Slut. Sir, she is retarded. She is disabled.
So? And what you gonna do about it?
Seriously, guys, when she tests you, test her right back. She trying to call you short. Well, I'm like, bitch, well, you could lose some weight. And if she, when she throw it at you, throw it at her right back. And like I told you, I bagged the girl that way. And it's not gonna always be see, a lot of times I think, oh, if you talk to a girl that way, oh, she's not gonna like me no more. I'm definitely not gonna get her number. Fuck all that. Don't be afraid of that. And if she do walk away, oh, fucking well. There's
no fish in the sea.
Exactly. You got to think as yourself. We are sharks, right? As men, we are sharks. They're fish. And I say sharks because we're superior, straight up. There's no way around that. A lot of girls don't like when I say that shit. Maybe it's my delivery, but they are not. We are not equal on that level. We're equal as human beings, right? But as men and women, we are not equal. We are sharks and they are fish. Now, there are less sharks. I'm not saying that just in general. I don't know if that's a fact, but I'm saying as men, there are less sharks and there are more fish.
There's like a million kinds of fish too.
There, in general, yeah, there's more fish. But I'm just saying as men, as an example, we are sharks. What you tripping over one fish? You think if I miss out on one fish, eating on one fish, there's a whole bunch of fish out in the fucking sea.
A shark still got to eat.
Exactly. I'm going to eat when I want. I'm the fucking king. I run this shit. Fuck, I look like tripping over one girl. One fish. Fuck out of here. Like a little music intermission break, Randy. We still on the podcast, guys. Guys, don't forget to drop your questions in the chat if you got questions. And when we're done with this podcast, we're going to get to it.
I'm guilty about it. Don't come down on me, that's just real nigga logic. If I can't win it with you, I still want you to win it. You more on that revenge shit. Goes to everybody outside that's looking, isn't it? Look, but all they care about is surface, and all I care about is everything that's under and in it. At the point where love gets replaced with resentment, I know time heals all, so just give me a minute. You question my commitment, I'm still yours. Just come with me for the week.
We could be a comedy. What's going on?
We got some good questions in the chat.
That shit is hard.
All right, let's finish off this podcast and we're going to get to these questions. All right, so just before we end this off, guys, just remember, put yourself first and don't fall under her pretty girl spell. Don't, like, I get it sometimes, and sometimes it's hard. Some of these girls be so bad, and you're like, damn, she got a fat ass. And when you just hitting it from the back, it be like, damn, she's so bad. It be like, oh, and I just want to give her everything. You know what I'm saying? But you can't fall under that spell. I don't care how pretty she is, because when you don't just give in to her, unlike most guys, like 90% of guys, you fall into that 20%. Because according to like all these fucking numbers, all these statistics that I've been reading and that I've been being told, 80% of women are trying to have sex with only 20% of men. That falls into looks and money. And if you got the looks and the money, you got to have game. Fall into those three. Fall into the 20% of men, 20-30% of men. That's so crazy. Because if you think about it, some guys don't have sex that much. If you look at niggas like me and myself and Randy, niggas in 20, the double digits and triple digits, it's like, damn. And you look at some guys and say, I only had sex with 10 girls my whole life, or 5 girls. Damn, nigga, what the fuck?
It's a lot of time to kill.
Yo, I had sex. I had 50 bodies before I left high school. I was on the move.
Yeah, I just caught 2 bodies yesterday.
Nigga, sweet, caught 2 bodies yesterday.
Huh?
This nigga, man. I think Randy trying to catch up. But the point is, when you refuse to give into her shit, when you refuse to be a simp, refuse, and you demand respect, I'm telling you. And just be, it has to be authentic. You can't fake the funk. Because if you try to fake the funk, she gonna see it. Girls have this weird thing of like seeing through shit. They have this weird thing of like
intuition.
Yeah, it's like that social calibration. If you're not calibrating, if you're saying something and your body language doesn't match, they can tell that shit is off. Girls are used to that shit because they've been getting hit on from a very young, especially if they look good. They've been getting hit on from a very young age. They always got guys that's after them. They know it. You can't fake it. This actually has to become who you are. This has to become who you are. You can't fake it. You cannot fake the funk. I'm telling you, because they will realize. All right, guys, let's end off this podcast, and then we're going to start taking some questions. Here, hit them with the music, Randy.
Hit them with the music.
I'm going to end it off. Podcast number 24. I think it's 24, right, Esteban? That's the boss. Say you said 23 yesterday.
47.
Ultra. Stand free to God, so my homie home. Okay. Gotta keep a Glock, niggas hating cause my money long. I can't tweak over thoughts, I got other hoes. Brody serving fiends on the block with a runny nose. He got wop, he got lean in his double cup. I just hit the scene for a band, watch I double up. Shake that ass, bitch, fuck it up.
I ain't dying quick, nigga.
To Miami for a tummy
tuck. I take my vitamins. Boom, boom. Exactly.
Hit his legs, watch him walk it out. He was playing tough, why the fuck you wanna talk it out? I just caught a nigga lacking at the Whopper House. Nigga,
mad vitamins, nigga.
Stupid when I'm popping out. Bad bitch, she gon' throw it back for a bunch of clout. Nigga say he wants smoke.
Hey, you been taking your CMOS?
Yeah. Really already spent the meal. I was already rich, I ain't really need a deal. I'ma change her life if I put her in this video. Flew her first class, she like, daddy, where we finna go? Made it out the hood, 248 to the 310. Niggas hating, saying I won't make it. I'm like, say no more, bitch. Stand free to God, so my homie home. Gotta keep a Glock, niggas hating cause my money long. I can't tweak over thoughts, I got other hoes. Brody serving fiends on the block with a runny nose. He got wop, he got lean in his double cup. I just hit the casino for a band, watch I double up. Shake that ass, bitch, fuck it up. I'ma send your ass to Miami for a tummy tuck.
Shake that ass, shake that bag, say you ride high. Look in the basement, yeah, on the table, bring off.
I got this weed in my lungs and this shit dope. Don't bring your bitch around me none, she gon' get poked. She gon'